Hello friends, welcome to this session of R data visualization with ggplot2. I am doing the scatterplot video again. Scatterplot is a very basic plot type which is used to visualize relationship between two numeric variables. This relationship can be linear, quadratic or others. By visualizing this relationship, we can decide on statistical model and use the statistical model to predict values of one variable using values of other variable. Let's go to the data. You may have your own data, but here I will use made up data for demonstration purpose. We are going to use this simulated data for the demonstration purpose, and this data has four numeric vectors. The first vector is concentration, and that is obtained by using function sequence. Lower limit is 0, upper limit is 100, and difference between two values will be 10. We'll run that. And here that concentrations are there, 11 readings are there, 0, 10, 20, 30, and we got that by using function sequence. Then absorbance readings taken by student A, there again a vector of 11 values is there, we will run this. And student B also readings are recorded, student C readings are also recorded. These three can be considered as replicate readings of each other. And all these four vectors, four numeric vectors have been stored into a data frame, DF underscore w is equal to data dot frame, and these four vectors are there as argument. We'll run that and we'll see head of this data frame using this head function, and these four columns are there. First column is concentration and three columns are absorbance readings STA, STB and STC. This type of table format is called as wide table, where same measurements are recorded as different vectors. Now, these different vectors can be brought together into a single vector because these are readings of same type. Here, it's a reading of absorbance. And this STA and STB, STC can be in a separate vector, and these three values will be levels of that other categorical vector. We'll run that and we'll use gather function to bring these three columns together, and that gather functions come from a package tidier. We'll call that tidier library, and if you have not installed tidier, install it using install packages. This install packages here, and I will run that tidier. Tidier functions are there. Now, name of the new data frame will be df long, because here we will get a long table where same type of measurements are in same column. Then gather function require first argument as data, that dfw we are going to use. And these three columns we are going to collect together, and these columns, names of these columns will be there in the vector stu, and values, these absorbance values will be stored into abs absorbance vector, and these three columns to be collected sta to stc. We'll run that and we'll see head of data frame, head df underscore l. We'll run this. That concentration column is there, student column is there. In student column, names of the student STA and readings taken by the student are there in absorbance. For all other student B, student C also, same thing will be there. Now, we'll go to plot these values using ggplot2. And to get ggplot2, we'll call library ggplot2. If you have not installed ggplot2, then install it through install packages from tools menu. We'll run this. Now we have run ggplot2. We'll start plotting ggplot. First argument of ggplot is data, that is df underscore l we are going to use. Second argument is mapping, aes aesthetics. In bracket, argument first will be the x-axis. We can say x is equal to, or we can omit that, because we are going to use in that order only. That concentration will be the x-axis, then absorbance will be the y-axis, and we'll run this ggplot function to see what happens. And now this function is not giving us the plotted values, but giving us a blank plot, and scales are there because we have specified this concentration as the x-axis. Here that x-axis, it is divided into scale, equal scale 0, 25, 50, 75, 100. And this absorbance is the y axis, and this is also divided into a proper scale. Now we'll add points, data points, using geom. Geom is for geometry. Geom, point is for scatter, and parenthesis will run this, and these points are there, but these points don't have any color. To give it color, we'll use color argument in this geom point. Color is equal to, in double quote, name of the color, that is red. But if we want to see the three different readings by three different students, then we have to map color aesthetics to students, color aesthetic to STU, then readings by these three students will be there as square. Now again, these circles are not discriminating properly between the three students. I think that therefore I will map it to shape aesthetics again. Shape is equal to STU, and these three students will have different shapes. I will run this, and these three students' readings have different shapes, and those shapes are there in the legend also, and this legend we got by default. Now we will see how to change size of these points. In geom point argument, we will have size argument. Size is equal to, and I will say it to be 5. These points will be slightly larger. We can change transparency of these points also, alpha, it looks good. And that transparency values will be 0 to 1, we will use 0.3. And these objects will be transparent, we will see the overlapping also. And 0.3 is quite less, therefore we will make it 0.6, we will run that. Okay, points are properly visible. And if we want to remove background to make the point graph clear, we'll use argument theme underscore black and white, and this theme black and white is there. Another theme is also there, we will try, that is pub r, and the legend will be at the top. Now the legend is at top, and quite elegant plot it is. We will add labels using the labs argument, labs, and this axis labels will change. First we'll go for the title label. Title is equal to scatter plot. Then x-axis label is equal to, in inverted comma, concentration. Y-axis label is equal to, in inverted comma, absorbance. This C shall be capital or uppercase. I will run this again. Okay. Now other aspects of the scatter plot are, we can have the geom smooth trend line. We'll add that, geom underscore smooth bracket complete. This has given us smooth with standard error also, and this is not looking good, therefore I will remove standard error using AC is equal to 0. But we require this plot to have a straight line, therefore we'll use method argument. Method is equal to lm. And when we run that, the straight lines will be there. These lines should pass through 0. I will use a formula for that. Y determined by x minus 1. And here I will have the formula name also. Formula is equal to y determined by x minus 1. This is tilde sign required for the formula. I will run this, and these lines are passing through 0. We'll see how to play with this shape. I will remove shape from the gplot argument, and here in geom point I will use the shape argument. Shape is equal to 3. All three will have same shape now, that is plus, and we'll change that to 7, and we'll see what happens. And we can change that to 16, see what happens. You can play with the shape argument also. You can play with the size argument also, and you can have your manual colors also. Similarly, you can play with any part of this code to get the graph of your liking. That's all for this session. Thank you for watching this video. If you have liked this video, please press the like button. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not subscribed yet. press the bell icon if you want notifications of my channel. And please share this video with your friends. Thank you.